गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? फाइन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑन इक्वेशंस ऑफ मोशन। सो फॉर फॉलोइंग न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑन इक्वेशंस ऑफ मोशन, वी हैव टू रिमेंबर सम फॉर्मूलेस एंड सम टर्म्स। सो द थिंग्स आर एज फॉलोज। फॉर सॉल्विंग problems of motion, remember the following formulas: first equation of motion, that is v equals to u plus at. Second equation of motion, that is s equals to ut plus half at square. S equals to ut plus half at square. Third equation of motion, that is v square equals to u square plus 2as. The fourth point which you have to remember is if a body starts from rest, if a body starts from rest, that means a body is starting from rest. If a body is starting from rest, that means the body is going to move. And when a body is going to move, that means it is not moving. That means its initial velocity. Initial velocity, comma u equals to 0. Fifth point, if a body comes to rest or stops, its final velocity, comma v equals to 0. That means if a body is moving and If a bike is moving and we are applying the brakes, so after application of the brakes, the bike stops moving. That means the bike comes to rest. That means its final velocity will be 0. If the body is moving with a constant acceleration, that means acceleration equals to how much? 0. Suppose a bike is moving with the same velocity, that means there is no change in velocity. And if there is no change in velocity, then acceleration will be how much? Acceleration will be 0. If a velocity or speed is given in kilometer per hour and you have to convert in meter per second, then directly you can multiply by 5 upon 18. To convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, multiply by 5 upon 18. So how it is happening? How we have got this number 5 upon 18? For that, as you know, kilometer. 1 kilometer equals to 1000 meters. Then hour. 1 hour equals to 60 minutes. 1 minute equals to 60 seconds. So in 1 hour, how many seconds are there? In 1 hour, 60 minutes into 60 equals to 3600 seconds are present. So now we are converting this kilometer per hour into meter per second. So for converting kilometer per hour into meter per second, what we will do? See, that means 1000 meter upon 3600 second. Two zeros are concerned. 2 5s are 10. What? 2 into 2, 1 into 16. So we have got 5 upon 18. So that means when you are calculating or when speed or velocity is given in kilometer per hour, you have to directly multiply with 5 upon 18. Understood? From 8 points to convert meter per second into kilometer per hour, again multiply by 18 upon 5. So here, if meter per second is there and you have to convert this meter per second into kilometer per hour, then you have to multiply by 18 upon 5. Understood? We have to write the given part. First of all, step one, we have to write the given part. Then we have to see which formula we can use, and then we have to put all the given parts in that formula, and then we have to solve the equation. So let us see what are the given parts. See, a scooter requires a velocity of 36 km per hour. That means a velocity is given in 10 seconds just after start means that the body is not started moving. That means here its initial velocity is given. Initial velocity is how much? 0. And so this velocity is its final velocity, and this is time. And what you have to find? You have to find acceleration. So you can write given initial velocity comma u equals to 0 meter per second. Why? Just after start. Final velocity, that means here the body is moving with 36 km per hour. Now, as you know, the SI unit of speed or velocity is meter per second. That means this kilometer per hour we have to convert in meter per second. So for converting kilometer per hour into meter per second, what we have to do? We have to multiply by 5 upon 18. That means 36 into 5 upon 18. 18 1 ja 18 2 ja, 2 into 5 10. So we have got 10 meter per second. Now time is given. Time comma t equals to how much? 10 seconds. So what we have to find? We have to find acceleration. We have to calculate acceleration. First to question mark. Now we have to see which equation we can use for finding acceleration. As you know, u is given, v is given, t is given, and we have to find a. So when you will see the first equation of motion, from first equation of motion v equals to u plus at. Then you will see that, see, this v is given, u is given, p is given, that means there is only one variable a. So from this equation we can easily calculate the value of acceleration. So now we will put all the values and we will calculate the value of acceleration. What is v? It is v 10, u 0, a we don't know, t 10. So that means 10 equals to 10a. So what is a? A equals to 10 upon 10, that is 1 meter per second square. So acceleration equals to 1 meter per second square. Understood? So now write the second question. A racing car has a uniform acceleration of 4 meter per second. That means acceleration is given. What is acceleration? Acceleration of 4 meter per second. So write the given part. Given acceleration comma a equals to 4 meter per second square. What distance will it cover? What distance will it cover? That means the body will cover how much amount of distance? That means distance comma s equals to question mark. In 10 seconds, in 10 seconds, that means time is given. T equals to how much? 10 seconds. After the start means the body has not started. The body is going to start. That means the body is in the state of rest. And if the body is in the state of rest, that means initial velocity comma u equals to 0 meter per second. Body at rest. So see, if you have got acceleration, you have got time, you have got initial velocity, and you want to find distance. So can you tell me which equation we are going to use? First equation, second equation, or third equation? See, in the first equation we can't use, because in the first equation there is no term of distance. So we have to use the second equation, or we can use third equation. So suppose we are using second equation. From second equation of motion, s equals to ut plus half at square. So we have to find s. S equals to what is u? U is 0 into time. Time is how much? 10 plus 1 upon 2 into a. A is 4 into time. Time is 10. 10 square. See, 2 under 2, 2 to the 4. Now see, 0 into 10, 0 plus 2 into what is 10 square? 10 square means? 10 square means how much? 10 into 10 equals to 100. So 2 into 100, that means s equals to 200 meter. So we have got distance equals to how much? 200 meter. A scooter is moving at a speed of 10 meter per second. It is stopped by applying a brakes. That means a scooter was moving. And when the scooter was moving, it was moving with a speed of 10 meter per second. And now, after moving some distance, the scooter was stopped by applying some brakes. That means the final velocity is 0. So write the given part. Final velocity equals to 0 meter per second.
like brakes to stop scooter. Initial velocity comma u equals to how much? 10 meter per second. This is v. This is how much? This is v. Now acceleration is given. What is acceleration? Acceleration equals to acceleration comma a equals to minus 0.5 meter per second square. How much distance will it cover by the scooter before it stops? That means, firstly, the scooter was traveling at a speed of 10 meter per second, and now, after some distance, the brakes are applied, and the scooter stops. So that means its final velocity is zero. Now, after how much distance? After how much distance the brakes are applied and it comes to rest? So we have to find out distance. Come on, ask the question mark. Now here v is given, u is given, a is given, and rest we have to find. Now can you tell me which equation we have to use? So here we are using the third equation of motion. So from third equation of motion, v square equals to u square plus 2as. We are using third equation of motion because, see, v is given, u is given, a is given, and s we have to find. So here, as time is not given, so we are not using second or first equation. We are using third equation of motion. So put the value v 0 square u 10 square plus 2 into what is a minus 0.5 into s. We don't know. See, 10 square 100, 2 into 0.5 minus 1, that means minus s. So we will take s here. S equals to how much? 100 meter. So we have calculated the distance, how much? It is 100. So these are the three problems which we have solved in today's lecture, and hope you have enjoyed today's lecture and solve all the three questions so that you can get a knowledge of problem solving in motion chapter.